ready to go. Didn't know what she was doing in a strange place, full of strange people who told her she couldn't go home. Not past this line here, they said, pointing to the yellow line over which we involuntaries were not allowed to step. Take these pills, they'll help you sleep, Maria. Take these pills. I don't sleep, I'm Maria. I want my home. I don't like it here. Take me home, please. I want to go to my home, please. She begged. The nurse rolled her eyes and went back to her newspaper. They'd had enough of Maria, who walked away slowly, sobbing as she went. Sobbing. And worries on the state of his mind. Andrew is a gentle soul who philosophizes and worries about whether he has been logical. Andrew is a gentle soul who converses honestly, then worries if he has offended anyone. Andrew is a gentle soul who swallows his tablets and wonders why he feels so ill. He talked about his memory, concerned he can't remember what happened. they first locked him up and gave him electric shocks and he wishes his brain would recover from the cruel treatment he still believes was necessary. He was sure he was divine. He sang about smiling colors and the fine line between madness and sanity, compliance and control, treatment and torture, treatment and torture. Michael was shaking because the drugs make him shake. Michael is shaking. He's shaking because the drugs make him shake. Suffering but laughed at the poison. Soup and thick soul, he chortled. I think we're zoo animals. But they can't put me down. They know that I'm special. They know my power. My special ability to make people laugh and sing. I'm a mental musician, he said. They can cripple my hands, but not my head. They can cripple my hands, but not my head. Michael said. Me some questions about matters I'd considered. She had a concern she could rarely share, that her brain was implanted by the CIA. She asked if I thought that this could be true, that a microchip had been surgically planted in her brain. I answered with what I thought I knew. I'm sure it's not possible, though they might if they could. The fact is they can't. She smiled and said, good. Jenny's delusion was why she was there, but nobody tried, especially hard, to ask why it was that she held this belief before drugging her for schizophrenia. She listened carefully to my opinion before smiling. It must have all been in my mind. 3 days later, she was discharged. The doctors convinced that their drugs had worked fine.